I know how important it is to address combat climate change. It's occurring three times faster in the north than it is in the south. So that's why I'm pleased that we are having this discussion, three First Nations working together to make meaningful progress in the transition to clean energies.
With various camps, and we utilize equipment that require electrical power. So we were able to see this opportunity to get support for reducing some of the fossil fuels in order to generate that power. And it turns out there we find other benefits as well, but we look forward to looking at our other camps and their needs and try to meet them in the same fashion.
So MGrid, we are a First Nation-owned company that has established to support northern communities to meet their electrical and heating needs through clean energy. We are now currently working with the Carcross Tagish First Nation in building two small district energy systems that use wood chips as the fuel source. That is another really neat project that we're working on.
We've made the commitment to be emission net zero in terms of greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. But in order to reach that target, we are going to have to work at so many different levels to make the transition to clean energy. Solutions and innovations and have to be led from the local level.
We went live April 1st, 2009. The revenues from that, own source revenues for the First Nation. And so far the citizens through joint clan meetings have mandated us to invest in what's called the Klatsini Fund, which helps Taku River Tlingit First Nation implement the land use plan negotiated with BC. Another thing that we got a joint clan meeting mandate to do was to invest $450,000 in this hydro expansion project, which we've done, and more. Is we developed a skills training employment program, and with collaboration with Human Resources Development Canada and Tricorp, invested approximately $1.5 million over the last number of years in skills training. We've developed a program that meets them where they are, helps them overcome barriers like childcare, transportation, and honestly, even, you know, substance abuse challenges.
We received funding then from CanOr, about $700,000, and we work in partnership with our local Yukon College here to assist us with developing a module. Continue to provide support to the farm because we strongly feel that food security is important. Last year, we received $500,000 from the federal government to put towards a three-season greenhouse about 10 months of the year, as well as they contributed based on providing an equal amount to us winning the $500,000 Arctic Inspiration Prize.
Right. Yeah, we're just trying to engage in very innovative solutions to food security, energy, and also using this farm as a way to employ people that are generally marginalized and have limited opportunities to employment. And the youth, trying to inspire youth to develop good work ethic initially as they start their career.
Part of what was so great about this project down there was that we got to take some people that worked for CTFN and other people that were citizens and take them down there, and they could just spend some time healing on the land while working and sharing breakfast and dinner and just being together away from the hustle and bustle.
To also down at this camp that we have down the lake. The solar panels is a benefit to our citizens as we go down there, because we use it also for a healing camp. We have a lot of our citizens that are going down there, and they help set up the camp, and it was really nice for them to be able to reconnect with the land. I know we had our men coming of age, their first hunts. They would go down and hunt down at this camp, and this is their kind of their base camp. And then we're also looking at providing one for the women so they could have their first hunt. And then they're learning how to set fish nets and how to prepare the fish and dry the fish. So it's also reconnecting with their culture.
And to express how much we appreciate the federal government's making climate change a priority, because here in the north we are impacted significantly, and the only way that we can make changes is continue to work on projects like these, and hopefully that will grow in the community as well.
Thank you so much. It's again, it's been a pleasure to see and to hear everybody. You're doing fantastic work in your territories. I could tell you that the work that you're doing is wholeheartedly supported by our government. Thank you.